नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
Now the word नीलक लोहिता also has another connotation. It is said नीलश्च लोहितश्च प्रधान पुरुष अन्वयात. So what it means here is that the Lord, who is the Purusha, is red and his Shakti, Maya, is blue. And Nila Lohita is one in whom both have come together. So sometimes the Lord is depicted as blue and his Shakti as red. Sometimes he is depicted as red and his Shakti as blue, which is to show that there is no difference between the Lord and his power. Like the power of singing resides in the singer. The power of speaking resides in the speaker. And whenever the speaker or the singer would like to invoke, they would invoke the power and utilize. In the same way, the power to create, sustain, destroy resides in the Lord, and the Lord manifests that power whenever it is necessary. In Hindu culture, Purusha and Prakriti are one. It is not that Purusha is superior, Prakriti is lower. They are one. Can the power to sing be lower and the singer be higher? They both are one. Of course, the singer can remain without the power to sing, but the power to sing is in the singer. In the same way, the Shakti of the Lord remains in the Supreme, is one with the Supreme. And whenever the Lord desires, the Lord manifests that power. This is said even in the Rudram Chamakam, in the 10th Anuvaka, it is said, Drape Andhasaspate Daridranila Lohita, which means that the Lord is the one who has the body of half male and half female, the Ardhanarishvara Rupa. There is also a Puranic story associated with this. It is said that Brahmaji created the whole universe, the three worlds, without the jivas, just the worlds. Then he created the four Sanat Kumars from his mind. But these Sanat Kumars were very dispassionate and they were seekers of knowledge. So they did not want to take the creation forward. It is at that time that Brahmaji prays to Lord Shiva with this desire in mind, that please help me to take the creation forward. And so it is at that time that Shivji appears in the Ardhanarishvara Rupa in front of Brahmaji and is pleased with Brahmaji's tapasya, and he gives the boon that Brahmaji desires. And so Brahmaji requests the Lord that please split into two parts, into two aspects. And so Shakti as Parvati and Shiva. So when they split for the sake of taking forth the creation, from the male aspect, the 11 Rudras are born, and from the female aspect, 11 Rudranis are born. So Ekadasha Rudra and Ekadasha Rudranis, they are born and they marry each other. And Brahmaji gives 11 abodes to these Rudras and Rudranis. Those 11 abodes are the senses, our 10 senses, and our subtle body. And the creation then went forth. So this is a story. But what is the symbolism of this story? That when the creation has to be taken forward, both Purusha and Prakriti are required. The matter and the spirit must come together, then the creation moves forward. And since it is Rudra and Rudranis who are the Amsha avatar of Lord Shiva himself, all the Jivas who are born are divine. All of us are one with that Supreme Lord. And since we are born from Nila and Lohita, we all also are called Nila Lohitas. We are also blue and red combination, a combination of Purusha and Prakriti, each one of us are. Right now, we are identified with the Prakriti, the perishable matter in us. The sadhana is to detach from Prakriti and realize the imperishable Purusha in us, and to discover that absolute Shiva Tattva, that Jiva and Shiva are one. That is the absolute bliss And so the word Nila Lohita indicates to us our own true divine nature, which we must reclaim.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.